Electricity is one of the fundamental forces in the universe, not only powering our devices and machines, but it is also key to natural phenomena such as the Earth's magnetic field, which is generated by electrical currents in the planet's molten outer core. But at the center lies the underlying principle explaining all electrical events, electric charge. This charge is what allows for the wide variety of electrical phenomena we observe, like rubbing a balloon against hair, causing hair strands to stand up. Charge is an essential property present in the electrons and protons of atoms that make up the structure and behavior of all matter. Electrons, which are negatively charged, are part of a fundamental group of particles known as leptons. Unlike protons, which are made up of quarks, leptons are indivisible and are not bounded by the strong nuclear force that hold quarks together. The behaviors of these charges, whether in the sophisticated workings of electronic devices or the grand scale of planetary magnetic fields, follow a foundational rule: the law of conservation of charge. This law states that the total amount of electric charge in an isolated system remains constant, meaning that charge can neither be created nor destroyed, only transferred. This is the unique ability of charge. The ability to move and be transferred from one place to another allows for the conversion of electrical energy into other forms, powering virtually all modern technology, from the simplest circuits to complex power grids. This flow of electric charge is what we call electricity. This movement typically occurs inside a conductor, such as a metal wire, when there's a path or circuit that allows the electrons to move. In conductors, the outer electrons of the atoms are loosely bound to their nucleus. These electrons and other charged particles like protons create an electric field around them by nature. This field represents the influence that the charged particle exerts on other charges in its vicinity. So when two charged particles approach each other, they are attracted or repelled by an electromagnetic force. This is based on the principles of Coulomb's law. Similar charges repel each other and opposite charges attract. The strength of this force is directly proportional to the product of the charges of the interacting particles and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So when an external electric field is applied to a conductor, it exerts forces on these loosely bound electrons, causing them to drift in a direction opposite to the field, creating an electric current. The ease with which a conductor allows the flow of electric current is known as its electrical conductivity. High conductivity means that the material allows electric charges to move through it more easily. Metals are the most common examples of conductive materials. In metals, the outer electrons are not bound to any specific atom. Instead, these electrons are shared and can move freely throughout the entire piece of metal. This is an important aspect of what's known as metallic bonding. Copper, aluminum, gold, and silver are particularly good conductors, which is why they are widely used in electrical wiring and components. Another good conductor is the human body, which contains fluids that are rich in ions, like sodium, potassium, calcium, and chloride, that move through our body. This movement is what allows electrical conductivity. When you come into physical contact with an electrically energized object, like a live wire, you introduce a new path through which electricity can flow. Since your body is conductive due to these ion-rich fluids, electricity can pass through it. This flow of current through your body can disrupt the normal electrical signals, especially those in the nervous system and the heart, which also rely on ion movements to function. The severity of the shock depends on the amount of current, the path it takes through the body, and the duration of exposure. Electric current can also be described as the rate of flow of electric charge over time. As said before, current has an inherent directionality. Conventionally, the direction of electric current is defined as the direction in which positive charges would move. Direct current is characterized by the unidirectional flow of electric charge, which means that the current is flowing in one direction. We see this typically in batteries. This is why devices that require a uniform power supply, like flashlights or remote controls, typically use batteries. However, in alternating current, the flow of electric charge periodically reverses direction. In an AC circuit, electrons move back and forth, changing direction at a regular interval. This type of current is used in most household power outlets, where it is generated by power plants and delivered through the electrical grid. The advantage of AC over DC for power distribution lies in its ability to be easily transformed to higher or lower voltages, making it more efficient for long-distance transmission. But to move the electron in a conductor in a particular direction requires work or energy transfer, which is performed by an external electromotive force. An example of this would be a battery. This electromotive force is also known as voltage or potential difference. The voltage between two points in an electric circuit is the energy, or work, needed to move a unit charge from one point to another. Like electric current, a constant voltage is called a DC voltage, whereas an alternating voltage is called an AC voltage. When this electromotive force performs the work needed to drive electrons through a circuit, it overcomes resistance and allows for energy transfer. In a circuit, there are two types of elements, active elements and passive elements. An active element is capable of generating energy while a passive element isn't. An example of active elements include generators, batteries, and operational amplifiers. While an example of a passive element in a circuit is a resistor. As electric charges move through a conductor, they can cause the conductor to heat up due to resistance. The amount of heat generated depends on the material's resistance and the amount of current flowing through it. This is because of the interactions between the moving electrons and the atoms of the material. As electrons move through the conductor, they can collide with the atoms in the metal. Each collision causes the electron to lose some of its energy, which is then transferred to the atom, causing it to vibrate more. This increased vibration of atoms is what we perceive as heat. This current-resisting behavior of a material is modeled by the resistor. By their nature, resistors are used to control the flow of current. Other examples of passive elements include capacitors, which are designed to store energy in electric fields, and inductors, which also store energy but in magnetically influenced areas. This is achieved when electric current flows through the inductor's coil, generating a magnetic field around it. The strength of this magnetic field is directly related to the amount of current passing through the coil. The key property of an inductor is called inductance, which is the property that opposes the change in current flowing through it. For instance, if you try to quickly increase the current, the inductor pushes back against this change by using the energy stored in its magnetic field to create a voltage that opposes the increase. This property makes inductors useful in various applications, such as filtering signals in electronic circuits, where they can help smooth out sudden changes in current. These devices help us control the flow of electrical energy, which allows us to make it do work for us, such as lighting up a room or powering a computer. Another fascinating way in which we use electricity is through electric vehicles, or EVs. Unlike traditional vehicles that depend solely on internal combustion engines for propulsion, electric vehicles use an electric drive system, either by completely replacing the combustion engine or by working alongside it to enhance efficiency and performance. There are four types of EVs: the hybrid, the plug-in hybrid, the battery or full electric, and the fuel cell. Hybrid electric vehicles combine the internal combustion engine with an electric motor. The electric motor works with the combustion engine, helping improve fuel economy and boost performance. Depending on the driving conditions, a vehicle can switch between the electric motor and the combustion engine, making it a versatile choice for various driving scenarios. The plug-in hybrid electric vehicle is similar to the hybrid, but has a larger battery pack that can be recharged from external source. This means you will have extended electric-only driving capabilities, while having the ICE as a backup for longer journeys. Fuel cell electric vehicles use a fuel cell to generate electricity onboard from hydrogen. The fuel cell combines hydrogen with oxygen from the air to produce electricity, which then powers the electric motor. The full electric vehicle runs solely on electric power stored in large battery packs. These vehicles are recharged from external sources, but without a combustion engine, they offer a silent, emission-free driving experience, often referred to as zero-emission vehicles. However, it's important to remember that the overall environmental impact of full electric vehicles depends on how the electricity used to charge them is generated. Electric vehicles also contain electric machines which convert electrical energy into mechanical energy for propulsion and vice versa during regenerative braking. This process not only propels the vehicle forward, but also captures kinetic energy during braking to recharge the battery, enhancing efficiency and extending the vehicle's range. The major advantages of an electric motor over an internal combustion engine is that the motor provides full torque or rotation at low speeds, and the instantaneous power can be 2 or 3 times the power of a regular motor. These characteristics give the vehicle excellent acceleration with a nominally rated electric motor. But while electricity already powers our daily devices and vast technologies and even drives natural phenomena like the Earth's magnetic field, we have only scratched the surface of what we can achieve with fully electric airplanes and electric propulsion systems and rockets, which propel missions deeper into space with unprecedented efficiency. Being some of the recent developments in the field, this makes the future of electricity incredibly exciting for humanity.